today's art lesson is honeybees. This art project celebrates the work and discovery of Dr. Charles Henry Turner. Today you will learn the parts of a bee, and you will draw a bee. Today you will create a scene from a honeybee's life, either a hive or a garden, or your choice.
Dr. Charles Henry Turner was a researcher and a teacher and America's first African-American entomologist. His work laid the foundation for what we know about insects' behavior. His knowledge has improved our understanding of everything from ecology to neuroscience. From an early age, Charles Henry Turner took an interest in insects. He read so many books about bugs, but the books did not satisfy his curiosity. So he began to study the natural world around him. Charles Henry Turner was the first African-American granted a PhD in zoology from the University of Chicago. His research showed evidence that honeybees can see colors and patterns. He was the first scientist to prove this. Dr. Turner published over 50 articles about insects. Today we tip our hats to Dr. Charles Henry Turner. He took the time to observe the world around him. His work helped shape the field of science.
Today we pay tribute to Dr. Charles Henry Turner. We will draw honeybees using lots of bright colors.
Let's get started. You will need mixed media paper, pencil, Sharpies, watercolor paint or crayons or colored pencils, your choice. Put your paper in whatever position you want. We're going to draw a bee on one of the corners you choose. Start by drawing the abdomen. Notice that I'm drawing my stripes curved. This will help to make your bee look 3D. You may also want to draw the stinger. Drawing the thorax. This shape is kind of round, but the lines are very angular. The thorax has a lot of furry texture. Draw short lines to show texture. Draw a circle for the bee's head. Also, draw two little circles for the eye compound. Using a fine point Sharpie, I'm shading in the bee's head, and now I'm shading in the stripes on the bee as well. Notice that my stripes are curved. This is what makes the bee look round and 3D. Drawing the bee's wings. From the thorax, draw first the front wing and then the hind wing. Bees have two sets of wings. I'm outlining my wing shapes with a fine point Sharpie. Now I'm dividing sections of the wing into different shapes. Using an ultra fine point Sharpie, I'm dividing the inside of the wings into more shapes. There are so many different sections inside of a bee's wing. Bee's wings are made up of a material called chitin. It's a lot like keratin, the material that makes up your fingernails. Drawing antennas. Draw two lines that are somewhat curved. Drawing the legs. The honeybee has three pairs of legs, which split into six segments, making them very flexible. The front legs are especially designed to clean the antenna, and the rear legs have a section devoted to pollen accumulation, called a pollen basket. Bees also have taste receptors on the tips of their legs. Notice how I'm drawing the bee's legs in three different sections. You might want to draw some lines around your bee to show that the bee is moving. I'm using a yellow marker to color in the yellow sections of the bee's abdomen. You might want to use crayons or colored pencils. And now to color in the thorax of the bee, I'm going to be blending yellow and brown to make a golden brown. I also want the thorax to feel like it has a texture, so I'm including some short lines in my shading. Bee's wings are translucent. To make them look somewhat translucent, I'm adding a little bit of purple and blue scribbles to them. Drawing the background. How do you want your background to look? Where is your bee? Is your bee on a honeycomb or on a flower? Honeycombs are made up of hexagon shapes. To draw a hexagon, draw two wide triangles. Connect the triangles with two straight lines. Now you have a six-sided hexagon. To draw a honeycomb, continue drawing hexagons. Fill your paper with hexagons. You might want to draw more than one bee on the honeycomb. Honeycomb is a golden yellow color, so I'm using my yellow marker. I'm going to paint some water over the marker so that the marker lines will blend in with the paper. Because we're paying tribute to Dr. Charles Henry Turner, maybe you want to have some fun with color. Since he was the one to discover that bees actually see in color, why not paint your honeycomb the color of rainbows? You could also include patterns. Is your bee on a flower? I'm drawing a bee that's just about to land on a flower. First, use your pencil to sketch your flower. I start with the center of the flower, and then I draw the flower petals. Remember, you're drawing from a bee's point of view. This is the way a flower looks like to a bee. I'm using a marker to draw the flower seeds, and now I'm painting over the center of the flower with some watercolor paint. You can still see the seeds underneath the watercolor paint, and that adds texture. What color are you going to paint your flower? I'm blending more than one color to make the flower look more interesting. Maybe your bee's not about to land on a flower. Maybe your bee is in an experiment. Maybe you want to draw one of Charles Henry Turner's bee experiments as the background. Where are you going to draw your bee? What are you going to draw in your background? I'm going to paint one more layer of blue in the background to make the flower really pop. What kind of art materials are you using? Crayons, colored pencils, watercolor paint, magic markers? Honeybees, an art lesson inspired by Dr. Charles Henry Turner and his love for bees.
I had so much fun drawing honeybees with you today. Please upload your finished artwork to our new Artsonia gallery. I can't wait to see the honeybees that you drew.